I became involved while I was at Newcastle Uni in a chapter of Engineers Without Borders Australia. Just sort of started off as conversations, you know, about social issues and people who were not necessarily as fortunate as ourselves. And then that grew into a wider understanding of the humanitarian space and ways in which I could actually apply what I learnt in my degree to assisting people. Humanitarian engineering is applying your engineering skill set in the assistance of people in crisis. That can look like many things. It can be natural disasters, it can be situations of conflict. It just depends on what's going on in the world and where you're deployed to, but when it comes down to it, it's using your engineering for the assistance of people in trouble, undergoing hardship. For the last few years, I've worked for Australian Red Cross as a civil engineer, specifically in the area of water. And some of my deployments going back over the last few years have been Iraq, Syria, and the more broader Middle East context, Lebanon, working in informal settlements. Prior to that was Nepal for the earthquake in 2015, and Sierra Leone for the Ebola outbreak in 2014. In all these contexts, and again going back prior to that, Yemen, the Pacific, you can apply your engineering in very different ways. It's whether it's in a health epidemic, in repair of infrastructure and water facilities. There's all sorts of ways that you can apply your engineering in this context. I never envisaged that it would take me down the pathway it has, but I'm really glad it has. I've got to meet amazing people, be involved in some incredible organisations that are doing some really good work in the world for the benefit of others. While I didn't necessarily know that going in, I soon learnt it from my time in Newcastle, and it's been a real pleasure.